That's right. It's happy hour. Okay, if the dad in your life drinks whiskey, you can't go wrong with getting him a great bottle for Father's Day.
Yeah, Sebastian Derbome, this gentleman over here, manager of brand advocacy at William Grant & Sons, joins us now with his top picks under $60. Sebastian, it's great to meet you. Welcome to Houston Life.
It's a pleasure.
And this is a great gift for dad.
Yes, it is. Thank you very much for having me. I have like an amazing selection for you for Father's Day and all different prices.
Okay, we love that. And I know, I think bourbon and whiskey is really having a moment, or the moment's been extended. It's been popular for quite some time.
It just keep on going.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. And okay. I have everything for you here. We're gonna start with an Irish whiskey, actually. It's called Tullamore Dew. This is the second largest Irish brand in the world. It's amazing. It's triple distill. It's blend with three different type of Irish whiskey, malt, pot still, and grain whiskey. So it's approachable yet complex, and for $24, you can't get it wrong.
We've featured this on the show before,
we
and we're fans. I didn't realize it was the second largest Irish whiskey in the world. So very popular.
Yeah, very popular. And you can have it with a beer on the side, some nuts, or you know, mix it with soda water.
And no, you drink it like this. You don't put the gentleman's cube in there. You just drink it
as you wish.
Okay.
Yeah, you can have it neat on ice or mix it up.
Okay.
It's up to you.
I prefer mine straight out of the bottle.
Ah, here we
go. Okay, what's this one?
This is Monkey Shoulder. So this is the blended malt. It's a blend of single malt from the region of Speyside in Scotland, some of the finest whiskey. And this is one of my personal favorite because it's great to mix with cocktails. Mm-hmm. So if your dad like mixing and make some cocktails, it's $32.99. It's super smooth. I describe it best as orange marmalade with a drizzle of honey on a warm toast.
I was going to say this reminds me of syrup.
Right.
So I feel like there it is. You just said it really nice though.
There
you
go.
You can feel it warming on the way down too, for sure.
It's great. Like I said, you can have it neat on ice, same, but it's great with cocktail. We've got plenty of recipe online. I invite you to go and check it out. Your dad would love it.
Okay.
It's for the new generation of whiskey drinker.
And I love how the color is changing too a little bit. So this next one is out of New York.
Yeah, so it's mostly part of the aging process, but also from the grain. So this is corn, okay? So this is a bourbon from New York, all right? The first ever bourbon created in New York. It's called Hudson Bright Light Big Bourbon, and it's also the first whiskey since Prohibition in the state of New York.
Okay, so Sebastian, can you break this down for us? Because I'd always heard that bourbon must come from Kentucky, but this is a bourbon from New York? How is that possible?
Yeah. Not necessarily. Like, the rules are such that, you know, you can be a bourbon. You have to respect another set of rules, but you don't have to be from Kentucky. It's a misconception that people have. And Ralph Arenzo, who is the founder of this this distillery, actually is at the forefront of the American whiskey craft movement, and he changed a lot for a lot of people across the U.S., you know, working with the laws and stuff like that. And you have about 1,800 distilleries all across the U.S. now because of him.
This one's really lovely. Yeah. It's a very smooth, I'm not a whiskey or a bourbon aficionado, but I'm looking at the notes here, and this one you have vanilla.
Yeah, bold flavor of vanilla and like salted caramel. And that's from an aging process in New Charred Oak. And the corn is found in New York, and it's $39.99. So it's great as a Manhattan as well, cocktail, old-fashioned, with a size of popcorn on the side.
I like the way you think.
That
is fantastic.
That is
I will say a big bang for your buck on that one.
Yes.
Okay, so this one, I know this one. My husband loves this. Baldini?
Your husband has taste.
He does have taste. Well, I mean, no, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Is it the most expensive one?
It is. It is. This is $59, around $59. Yeah, this is the single malt. This is for the whiskey aficionados, the connoisseur. This is a single malt, a Scotch whiskey.
Mm. Nice.
All right? Yeah, this is rich, complex. It's made by David Stewart, who was he's a malt master, and he created a like a finishing process. You know, this is a double wood, so he spent 12 years in American oak, and then after he's finished in European oak for a 9 months period of time. So to add complexities and layer to the whiskey, that was a unique process that he created himself in 1982.
This is really lovely, and I thought this one was smooth. This one, it takes it to a whole nother level.
And it's incredible how each one is just a little bit different, and I love that you brought us, Sebastian, a range of price points.
Right, so all price point, all different style, you know, from $24 all the way to $60, but you can't go wrong. Either way, whatever you choose, you're not going to be happy.
And very impressive list as well. Sebastian, thanks so much.
Hey, it's a pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Well, next time you need to bring a third glass so you can sip.
Yes, I will. In the meantime, you know, please enjoy the whiskey.
Thank you. Happy Father's Day.
And by the way, guys, for the complete list of all these whiskeys that we tasted today, head over to our website, HoustonLife.tv.
Sebastian Derbome, thanks so much. Now let's check back in with Joe Sam, who's helping us celebrate Flag Day today. Hey, Joe.